What's good, y'all? So I wanted to get on here actually and just share something that happened to me recently, credit wise. You know, not everything that glitters stays gold or is gold. What's that saying? How that saying goes. So, sad day in credit right now. Now, this isn't about credit repair, this is just about credit and a sign of the times. Banks are becoming more stingy when it comes to lending out money. And for the average person, I consider myself an average person. You know, people will see their credit limits getting slashed. Even if you pay everything on time, you don't have any weird activity, etc., etc., right? So that happened to me recently. American Express has been on a slashing spree, right? So just maybe like a couple of days ago, I wanted to make a purchase. And with Amex, they're very particular. They take a lot of things into consideration. They're always checking up on their customers, their clients, and monitoring what they spend, how they spend. So I wanted to make a larger purchase because I wanted to take advantage of a particular perk that they had, right? And they said, oh, well, okay, you know, go ahead and make the purchase. And then after making the purchase on one of my cards, I got four cards with Amex, they actually slashed one of my credit cards from like $22,000 all the way down to like $5,500, which is fucking crazy, especially since my limit was higher than that prior to them cutting it, right? So what can you do about it? Of course you can just wait it out, right? Or what can I do about it? I can just wait it out and, you know, use the 90-day situation. Use the card regularly, pay it off in full, blah, blah, blah. And then on 91 days, I'm going to ask them to raise the limit again. I could challenge it. And that's also a long process. May end up just still waiting 90 days for the same result, right? And so I'm blown because these type of slashes happen without any warning, right? And even without you necessarily having done anything quote unquote wrong. So full transparency though, I am currently carrying a balance on my business Amex because it's 0%. I mean, why would I rush to pay that off, right? I used that to make an investment with the return. So, yeah, I'm going to take my time to pay it off. But where I still messed up at is that I did this, even though 0% is still their charge card. It's still the Platinum business card. So it's kind of interesting that they bother giving you a 0% interest on a charge card. Like, it's kind of no point of having 0% interest on a card that they want you to pay in full every month. But nonetheless, I'm experimenting with it. You know what I'm saying? What's the worst that can happen? This is the worst that can happen. They slashed my limit by $16,000, which is crazy. So now what's going to happen? That's going to impact my credit utilization, because it's going to show overall that I have less credit available. Not that any of my cards are like maxed out or anything like that. It's just you have to think about your entire credit profile and how that is going to impact your credit profile, right? So it basically reduced how much credit I have available overall. And the crazy part is this, they slashed the limit on a card that I don't really use that often. You know, I put it up for a couple of months and they were like, hey, you know, You know, if you use your card more often, we can go ahead and increase your spending power, et cetera, et cetera. Oh, okay, cool. Let me do that. So I did. And then they were like, oh, we're going to cut your limit. So do y'all want me to spend the money or not, Sway? Like, which one is it? You know what I'm saying? Like, which one do y'all want? Either you want me to spend the money or you don't want me to spend the money. And so, you know, I aired it out or made a post about it in one of my other groups. And a lot of people have been experiencing this. And it's not really unusual, to be honest. Once you have higher limit credit cards, 20, 30, 40, 50,000, etc., and it's in times of recession, they do typically slash those cards first because they consider those higher limits as more risky. Right, and they consider when you have given someone a $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 credit limit that the person, especially times of recession and people are getting laid off, and especially after the pandemic, there are a lot of people that still quit their job and never went back. They feel that there's higher risk of a person basically living off their credit cards and then just simply defaulting. So to protect themselves, what they do is that they just go ahead and slash your limit with no warning, right? Even though when you call Amex and you say, hey, you know, can I go ahead and spend this and that, whatever, they're like, oh, nah, you don't really spend that much on the card to begin with. You have to spend more and then pay it off so that we can see that you're spending more. I'm like, what the hell? All right, cool. Fine, I'll do that. And then when I did it, they slashed my damn limit. Ain't that some shit? I wanted to share that with y'all. This is not even a plug to assist you with improving your credit. I just wanted to let y'all know some things that's going on outside, right? Even for people with good credit, you know, decent credit, moderate credit, whatever, you know, no late payments, no collections. None of that stuff. Still got my limit slashed because I wasn't using the card enough, right? So, and because I'm carrying a balance on my business card. I think it's because I'm carrying a balance on my business card. I don't really feel bad about carrying the balance though, because I'm using it to make an investment and it's 0%. Like, y'all gave me a 0% card. Why wouldn't I carry the balance for 0%? Don't make sense. But anyway, just wanted to put that out there so y'all know what's going on. And, you know, keep it 100 with y'all. You know what I'm saying? It's not like I'm going to be able to freaking get approved every time I apply. Credit limits getting slashed is part of the game. It happens. The bright side is that as long as I continue to use the card or just use my credit properly, that the limit will increase. That's another great thing. Keep in mind, everything that's on your, nothing on your credit or that's happening with your credit is permanent. It's all situational, right? Or I should say temporary. Well, a little bit of both. Situational and temporary. As the data points on your credit improves, that will open up more opportunities. So things like reducing your credit utilization or your credit usage, right? Making sure you make those payments so that it can be recorded by the statement date and the reporting date, so you'll have lower usage, right? Getting those late payments removed, as calling them, asking them to remove the late payments, piggybacking, you know, being added as an authorized user to give you more age on your credit. Okay, as you do these various things, that's going to improve your credit profile and that's going to open up more opportunities for you. I mean, I know people who currently have over $300,000 in credit, but 10 years ago they had to file bankruptcy. All right, I know people who have 2 homes and 4 cars right now doing very well who had to file bankruptcy in the past. It's temporary. the key to it all is making sure that you decide that it's not going to happen again, right? It's temporary, and you're going to work your way out of it to and never get yourself back in it. Okay. Now, if you are in a situation where you have some late payments, collections, BKs, bankruptcies, you want them removed or you need some assistance getting those things removed, definitely holler at me. Definitely set up a consultation. That's no issue. But I still wanted to share that with y'all. It was just on my heart because it real live, it blew me. I was blown. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. I was real live upset that these bastards cut my limit. Because once they give it to you, you feel like it's yours. Like, dang, y'all just took my money away. Like, what y'all doing? For no apparent reason. Like, I know I wasn't using it, but damn, it's nice to see that it's there. You feel me? Like, that's crazy. But anyway, y'all, you know, it was good talking to y'all. Hopefully you tap in. You know, and if this has happened to you, please let me know. Let me know how it turned out for you. My bad. I'm writing. I'm still going to put the link here to set an appointment, even though I'm not even talking about setting an appointment. But, you know, if that's something that you need, you want to talk about, less rap. All right, but anyway, that was about it. It's a beautiful, gloomy day in Maryland. I'm gonna talk to y'all. Y'all be easy, all right?